Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, everyone. Hope I'm audible.
Yes, alhamdulillah, sister.
Alhamdulillah. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidni ilma. Rabbi zidni ilma. Rabbi zidni ilma. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaba. I welcome you all with an Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My beloved brothers and sisters, first of all, let's be grateful to Almighty who gave us all this opportunity to catch up even during this pandemic. And kindly I request, you know, you to bear with me since I'm at my work even today at Ripon Corporation. So listening to all your lectures and explanations, maybe like the introduction towards an academic and Islamic education and all, it was like mind-blowing, and I was totally lost working here, and I was totally like involved in this particular session. And now my doubt is, how do I go about my session? Because both my students, Sister Abida and Sister Janira, had covered the entire theme and concept, so I think it would be we can make it more interesting through interactions, inshallah, if you would permit me. And once again, I remind you, as like Sister Janira told, I am one among you. It's not like a guest speaker or a person who comes here to give you suggestions or like, you know, guidance. Take me, treat me as one among you. And like, you know, chats, I don't think so it will work out. It can be more like interaction by maybe by the host or like someone. So we can go ahead with that. Is that okay, Sister Zahira? I think like most of you are familiar to me through AHI. I was the vice principal and coordinator of AHI, Anjuman-e-Himayat-e-Islam. Am I audible, sisters?
Yes, sisters.
Yeah. So the thing is, I personally feel that live sessions and live classes works well, but it's like really hard because I conduct most of my classes, webinars, like sessions through the web. And it's very hard for us to, you know, deliver the message, convey the message, what we actually have to. But still, let's take this as a challenge, an open challenge, and I think we'll go ahead with the session. So can you make me the host so that I can post the slides, inshallah? Alhamdulillah. Sister Abida invited me just to, you know, acknowledge and address few points where like we can correct ourselves, maybe like improvise ourselves in parenting, and all I had was yes, because it's the need of our. And alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, listening to all the you know, explanations through Sister Zahira, Sister Abida, Sister Janira, and looking into all the comments, I felt like, yeah, as a psychologist and as a public, it's actually the need of our. So looking forward, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Parenting with passion. You know, parenting is not a job. It should be a passion. The sign of great parenting is not the child's behavior, but the sign of truly great parenting is the parent's behavior. Remember that. Now, we think my child's behavior is somewhere lost. We always use those words. And sister, one more thing. Should I go ahead with English or should I, you know, bile it up, like bilingual? Hello? Sister Zahira?
Yes, sister, you can give us the speech in bilingual.
Yeah, okay, because I heard that parents are also joining, and so that would be like easy for them also to understand. So, the first slide which I have, you know, posted here, the sign of great parenting is not about child's behavior. Remember that, because we usually comment on my child's behavior is not that proper. I don't know how to correct him. I don't know how to correct her. Always we try to blame them, in the sense like, enna senjalume enoda kulandhukku changes varala. Changes varala abindra oru vishayatha vandu we try to, you know, poke. But I remind you here, the sign of truly great parenting is the parents' behavior. So let's start thinking in a different perspective. Instead of looking into the child's behavior, let us check us. Let's check within us. Like, what's the behavior that I should change? a journey towards effective parenting. So let's start a journey, maybe like 30 minutes. I don't want more much of your time. I'll make it short and crispy. So a journey towards effective parenting, parenting from the heart. It starts parenting, looking into the, you know, statements or the points or like whatever the messages from the part of parenting through our hearts, inshallah. First of all, I would like to, you know, inform that parenting is gardening. The universe blooms in face of child by bringing out the best in your child. You bring out the best in this universe. Just imagine, garden la nariya flowers, nariya beautiful flowers. It blooms and it gives, it's kind of like beautifying the entire universe. So where is it? It's not required. Being a garden theory, po your flowers, the colorful flowers, the afternoon, avasiola. Look at your child's face. How can you bring that blossom, you know, and the beautification? How can you bring the smile in that child's face? Bring out the best in her or him. So it's not that easy, my dear sisters and brothers. Bringing a smile, a proper smile, without any fake or without any mask. Bringing out a child's smile is the highest task, I would say, to every parent. Remember that. Parenting is a trust. The biggest trust is being entrusted with a life. The biggest responsibility is to live that trust throughout our life, your life. So parenting is not just a responsibility, it's a trust. ஒரு நம்பிக்கை, ஒரு குழந்தைய நம்ம வளர்த்துறோம் அண்ட் அந்த குழந்தை என்னோடது அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் இட்ஸ் 100% ட்ரஸ்ட் விச் த சைல்ட் ஹேஸ் ஆன் அஸ் லைக் வைஸ் வர்சா வி ஹாவ் ஆன் அவர் சில்ட்ரன். ஸோ ரிமெம்பர் தட் வாட் யூ இன்யூஸ் இன் தெம், இன்சிஸ்ட் இன் தெம். இன்னைக்கு நீங்கள் விதைக்கிறது தான் நாளைக்கு செடியாக மரமாக வளர்கிறதுக்கு நிறைய நிறைய வாய்ப்புகள் இருக்குது. ஸோ ரிமெம்பர் தட் இட்ஸ் எ ட்ரஸ்ட். ஸோ த சைல்ட் இஸ் ட்ரஸ்டிங் யூ 100% blindly or like without even thinking, like for a second thought illama the child is trusting you. Maybe like 15s la irukanga, if 18s la irukanga, what would I do, sister? Abina, no problem, we are still your children, still our children. We can mold them in the way we want and how, like how Allah and Shahabaz and even the prophets had diverted us and commanded us. We have still hopes. Parenting is labor of love. The sleepless nights, the career sacrifices, the postponing of your so many activities. The price of parenting comes at a price. The price of parenting comes at a price. எதுவுமே அவ்வளோ சீக்கிரம் கிடைச்சிடாது இல்லையா. ஸோ பேரண்டிங் அப்படின்னு வரும்போது வி நீட் மெனி எஃபர்ட்ஸ், மெனி சாக்ரிஃபைசஸ், மெனி மெனி சாக்ரிஃபைசஸ் அண்ட் வி போஸ்ட்போன் ஆல் அவர் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ். ப்ரியாரிட்டி மேட்டர்ஸ் அலாட். ப்ரியாரிட்டி பிகாஸ் ஆர் சில்ட்ரன் ஆர் அவர் அமானா. So once again, I'm like nailing it on it. Our children are our amana. Don't take them for granted at all. We think, "Yen kolanda thana na adikalam. Enak urime irukku. Na enna venalum pannalam." Never ever take your children for granted. They are your amana. And imagine, oru thonga namakku oru porul kudukuranga and na vandu adha just like that lethargica, okay, thooki vesura and I play with that and I don't take proper care on that. And tomorrow one fine day when that person comes to me and asks, "Where is the like property or the material?" And that fear will be always there. Anik vandu ketanga na enna panna porom appindrathu. So what we'll do is we take care of it because that person had trusted me and he had given it to me. So when he comes back or when, if at all, if he asks about that material, it should be safe and protected. So we always have that intention, even if it is a small like materialistic stuff. So these are like, you know, உயிருள்ள அல்லாஹ்வால கொடுக்கப்பட்ட ஒரு பிகெஸ்ட் ப்ரீஷியஸ் கிஃப்ட்ஸ் விச் வாஸ் கிஃப்டட் டு அஸ் த்ரூ அவர் ரப். ஸோ மேபி டுமாரோ வி வில் ஹாவ் டு ஆன்சர், வி வில் ஹாவ் டு ப்ரெசென்ட் அவர் செல்ஸ் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் அல்லாஹ் சுப்ஹானஹு வ தஆலா. ஸோ வாட் வில் பி யுவர் ஆன்சர்ஸ், அவர் ஆன்சர்ஸ்? ஸோ தே ஆர் அவர் ப்ரீஷியஸ் கிஃப்ட்ஸ் விச் அல்லாஹ் ஹட் கிஃப்டட் அஸ். ஸோ புட்டிங் இன் அவர் எஃபர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் யூ நோ giving our 100% is the real price of parenting. It is the real price of parenting. And parenting is enjoying. Smiling together singing songs, playing together with your child are most enjoyable moments of life. So, you know, parenting, it's not like oru velaya nenikadinga, oru art, oru kala. It's not a burden. It's not a job. Try to enjoy it, feel it. Because, you know, parenting is one awesome thing which makes us to lead a life. Like, okay, go ahead. Innu polam. We'll never give up on any actions of us. Even if we are like bombarded with so many other stuff and we are like, you know, totally tired in and out. But still, one hope which we have is like, how can I leave my children and move? I can never ever give up.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, sister.
Sister, your voice is breaking. Just please, I want you to be a little clear.
All right.
Sorry for the interruption.
No problem, no problem. I told you, please correct me and give me suggestions because I'm still at my work at Wickham Corporation. I've taken a break of 40 minutes and they've like come. So you can always give me suggestions because I'm like totally blind without like no live session. So no problem. Am I audible now, sister? Am I clear now?
Now it's clear.
Yeah. So, parenting is enjoying. I was just telling that statement. Smiling together, being with them. No, it's the most enjoyable moments of life. So maybe like start enjoying and, you know, seriously focus on the moments to cherish. Instead of like always, why is my child like this? Eppadi pandrathu, enna pandrathu? She's not listening to me. She's not obeying. She's not like literally like, you know, the way I want. Don't. Never. Try to enjoy even during their mischiefs, during their, you know, faults, during their flaws. Nothing wrong in it. Practically speaking, like practically, we must know what is parenting. Meeting the child's needs to age of 18, sometimes even longer. Guiding the child towards the goal of becoming a competent adult. So we think like, yeah, you've grown old enough. 9 years aayiduchu unakku, 12 years aayiduchu unakku, or maybe like 18. Still children. Yeah, our children. Even we know as parents, especially mothers, 25, 30s vandhalume, we take them as our little children only. So why now? 9 years la, 5 years la, you don't know like how many parents treat children. I had one experience where I got a parent for counseling and she had come back from the radiations which was done to a 2.5-year-old child for speech. And then I got to know she was comparing her child with her brother's son who was like 2 months elder to the little girl. And she was telling like 3 years aachu ponnu pesa maatingra ana avanukku 3 years, 2 months tha aachu avlo pesuran. So she had admitted the baby, little baby, in a hospital and she had given complete treatment throughout the tongue and la hawla wala quwwata illa billah. May Allah protect all of us from all these, you know, misguidings and comparisons which we really treat them like a, I don't know what word to use, seriously. Looking at many parents, even, you know, if they have the Islamic knowledge, even still they are the da'is and, you know, the well-known, fabulous and famous speakers and renowned Islamic scholars. They had like ended up with these, like, you know, dunya desire, dunya, like, you know, legitimates which we fail to understand at times. We fall into the traps of shaitan. And it was really a shock for us to look into that little girl's tongue. And you don't know, it took like hardly 1 year for us to bring out of that particular injury with that little girl had in her tongue. For what? Speech. She was unable to spell well, maybe the pronunciation. So it is not about the comparison, or it is not at all about how my child shines. It is about what I do with my child. And you know what? Finally, the parent was given training to speak with the child. Both mother and father are working outside and the child doesn't have anyone to speak. At the age of 2.5 and 3, believe me, not bluffing things. It was a real incident which I had to handle, and I think like Stabida and few of my colleagues would know about this case. And when we gave the parents proper training on how to deal with the child, it took hardly 1 year, but subhanallah, the child came out of all the injury and she was like, subhanallah, she was like beautifully singing the rhymes and speaking to everyone. And it was a blunder which the parent, even now she has that regrets, what had I done to my child. So, you know, prevention is always better than cure. Don't forget that, just a reminder. So now let's look into parenting myths and realities. Myth one, we think like all parenting skills are instinctive. But the fact is, no one is born with all the preparation needed to be an effective parent. You understand? We think like adellame naturally it is there. Ella parent na kalyanai kuzhandha piranda ellarkume andha or natural instinct fitra irukum appadina we think it's a myth. No one is born with all the preparations. No, not at all. We are not like 100% perfect even now, even at the age of 50s and 60s. Many parenting skills must be learned through experiences, through gaining knowledge. Definitely through experiences. Day by day, day by day, year by year, we will be experiencing new things. When my child is 2, I'll have a different perspective. When my child is 12, I'll have a very different perspective, because age of adolescence, teenage, you must know the growth. Last evening, I got a call from a parent where she says like, she was very quiet and calm all these years. But now she's back answering me. She never listens to me. So one question which I asked the parent was, what's the age of your daughter? She says like, it's 13. So 100% is like obvious for us to understand. The age of adolescence, the hormonal changes, the bodily changes, which he or she will have to undergo. Maybe like nammalam valandathu appadi ella irukalam without like proper knowledge, or like just like that we have like, you know, grown. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah for that. But now the food, the hormones, the secretions, everything is totally different, brothers and sisters. Because, you know, being in this department of psychiatry, it's like totally disturbing and deviating every little children from their behaviors, from their understandings, from their perspectives. We as parents, it's our duty to learn, to understand, to apply in our child and get experience. Myth two, a mature adult can be a perfect parent, is it? We think, okay, poga poga oru periya parents ah irundanga na, aged parents ah irundanga, they had given birth to 5 or 6 children. So now after all the 3 or 4 children, or maybe 5 or 6 children, they'll be experienced. So nalla adult ah irukanga, so they can be a perfect parent. No, the fact is humans are not perfect, so no one can be a perfect parent. Humans are not perfect, so no one can be a perfect parent. It started with one simple rule, sister. No yelling in the mornings. Okay, never yell your children in the mornings. You are allowed to be tired. Okay, you get tired, you get stressed, annoyed, mad, because understand one thing, even our hair will not cooperate with us, or pee because your shorts didn't make it to the dryer. So what will happen to us? Like, my hair dryer is not working for me. Will I yell at the hair dryer instead focusing on how long as we, like, you know, communicate to make it calm and work well? So or material ke nam avlo respond pannumbodhu, why do we yell at our children for not doing their work properly? Instead, just opposite, think opposite. No, calm, aram se, just think for a minute, what should be done, how should the child be treated. Even at the age of 40s, 50s and 60s, when we have the attitude of, you know, dealing things romba porumaya, untangling the wires, maybe the headphones or the chargers, and we think like, okay, I have so much of experience with all the technology, so I can untangle it so easily and solli ella pudichu iluthona, what will happen to that wire? Will that function well? So these are all materialistic stuffs. We are talking about a body, a physic, a child which has flesh, blood and life in it. It's a higher responsibility, and, you know, periya 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 porupulla oru vishayam dealing the child. Kama porumaya irundhu, mature adults should strive to become even more better, like, you know, competent parents, not perfect parents. Don't try to be a perfect parent, that will not work, that will never work. It's not like a easy task. Avlo sikrama neenga vandu oru kulandhai valathi oru 18 vayasu 20 vayasu best eppume perfect ah kondu vara mudiyadhu, sisters and brothers. It's not at all possible. And unless and until like Allah blesses us, like oru smooth ah அப்படி போறதுக்கு. Of course, even அந்த மாதிரி குழந்தைங்க கூட, when they like, you know, take a turn and 12 words towards their ages and the adolescent period, they will drive us crazy like anything. mark my words. 4 years தாவது ஸோ நான் இப்போ இஸ்லாமிக் ஸ்கூலில் போட்டுட்டேன் இந்த எஜுகேஷன் கொடுத்துருக்குறேன் ஸோ சூராஸ் டீச்சிங்ஸ் யூனோ கலிமாஸ் ஆல் தி தில்பியா எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் டன் அட் ஹோம் வி டூ ரிசைட் வி டூ டீச் வி டூ ப்ராக்டிஸ் வி என்ஜாய் எல்லாம் சொல்கிறவங்க கூட இட்ஸ் அ ரிமைண்டர் டோன்ட் ஃபர்கெட் தே வில் ட்ரைவ் அஸ் ஆல் லைக் கிரேசி கோர்ஸ் டோன்ட் ஃபர்கெட் பிகாஸ் யூனோ இட்ஸ் ஹியூமன் டெண்டன்சி மேபி த ஜென்ரேஷன் ஆர் த மில்லினியல் பிஹேவியர்ஸ் வாட் எவர் இட் இஸ் Myth 3. Good parenting guarantees good children. Is it real? Really? Let's check it out. But the fact is, of course, yes. As I said right now, good parenting at the young age guarantees good children. Yes, of course. I don't deny it. But the fact is, influences outside the family, such as peers, adults, other than parents, and media affect children in healthy or unhealthy ways. And I'm very sure about all our kids ipo in the pandemic la in the corona crisis la they have really gone mad like they are like really lost and even parents more than them parents like we are like you know facing it's a global crisis sisters and brothers nothing to worry everything will come to an end inshallah very soon and we'll be normal maybe like take this as a opportunity to learn us to master our studies in parenting and observing children observing us individually personally and getting back all things set very soon inshallah so this technology is a major cause for all the influences like how it has totally influenced and deviated my child yes of course we can and we still have hopes if today is lost we always have a tomorrow don't forget it myth 4 parenting is always fun is it Not at all. But the fact is, like any other job, parenting can be fun, sad, exciting, boring, satisfying, and frustrating. Adults should have realistic expectations about parenting. So, yes, of course, we can get agitated, annoyed, and pissed off at times. No problem. But get back. Sit back to your positions and calm down yourselves. Because we multitask. Reason parents, like both mother and father, they multitask. All we need is like never have that reluctancy, timid, squeamish, nothing such. All we have to understand is every day and every single scenario is all about the experience. So these are passing clouds. Idhuvum kadandhu pogum. Nichayama, idhuvum kadandhu pogum. So keep reminding, keep working with our children, like within yourselves too let's check it out what kind of parents are we parenting styles and its outcomes if we are authoritarians like limits without freedom or limits e illama freedom kuduthidrom beginning la these parents are extremely strict and are often cold they communicate through lectures yelling punishment and one-sided discussions they decide only that will be done and the decision will be forced and pressurized towards the child or enna solradhu or vishayatha decide panniruvaanga and the decision ullave like insist panni induce panni force panni they want the child to be how they expected and in the idudeya repercussion eppadi irukum outcome eppadi irukum Like, you know, they'll be obedient, distrustful, no expression of freedom at all, withdrawn, unhappy, hostile, not high achievers. Remember that. They'll be obedient, of course, because they fear you. They're like totally like, they get panics. Father, mother, pre-expect that. So I have to be in the show. Abdin Rappa. They'll be obedient. But do you think they are living a life? Not at all. They die before their life. They literally... die before their life they'll be obedient of course but distrustful no expressions of freedom will be experienced felt or like you know rejoiced by them they are mostly unhappy and they can't achieve more or many things very few and the fire la work pannumbodhu very few achieve but many of them fail so just a reminder about my previous slide whether we are a parent of like authoritarian, authorizing things, commanding, demanding, and forcing. Next, are we a parent of permissive freedom without limits? On the other extreme of the parenting spectrum is permissive parenting. As the name suggests, permissive parenting is more of an anything goes attitude. Anything goes. Okay, ennanalu paathukalam. These parents do not attempt to exert any sort of control over their children. So, hope you understood. What will be the outcome? Aggressive? No, we tamper. Namma vandu enna nenichukrom? Okay, namakku kedaikada nariya vishayangal. Namakku nadakkada vishayangala enoda kulandikitta namma vandu paathu I'm enjoying. That's not the way to bring up our children, sisters and brothers. Most of us fail to understand this important fact in our lives. And just again a reminder, as Sister Janira mentioned already, for you and I are taking this as a reminder. It's not about giving fulfilling all the needs of my child which was lost in me someday. No, it is all about teaching them how to overcome those obstacles when they have it or not, training them both physically and mentally how to be moderate when they have it or not. So if we tamper too much, one fine day the outcome, with our children will be aggressive, least self-reliant, least self-controlled, least exploratory, mostly unhappy. So nenacha nadandrum nenachadala kedachirum. Because என்னோட parents அதுதான் எனக்கு செஞ்சிட்டு இருந்தாங்க. 2 years, 3 years-ல அப்படி பண்றாங்க. 7-8 years-ல எல்லாமே அப்படி செஞ்சிட்டாங்க. என்ன சொல்ற பிளே ஸ்டேஷன் வேணுமா, வாட் எவர் மச் லாஸ் இட் வாஸ் லைக் இன் ஹேண்ட். பட் நவ் த மேஜர் இஷ்யூ, 12-year-old child is committing suicide. 10-year-old child calls me and says like, ma'am, I want to kill myself. 7-year-old child calls and says like, I have failed in my love. So what's wrong with our children? It's because at the age of 3 and 4, we give them freedom for whatever they ask. We never restrict. We say like, chinna kolanda dane, chinna ponnu dane, so I can go ahead. But when they reach their 10s and 12s, maybe like 16s and 17s, we understand it's wrong. We let them wear mini skirts and sleeveless tops at the age of 3, 4, 5, 6. And when they grow up 13s to their 12s and 13s, we stop it. So what will my child look at me and ask? Are you mad? நீங்க தானே எனக்கு இதெல்லாம் வாங்கி தந்தீங்க, இப்போ எனக்கு அந்த ட்ரெஸ் தான் பிடிச்சிக்கோ, ஐம் கம்ஃபர்டபுள் வித் தட், ஐம் சஃபகேட்டிங், இட்ஸ் ஆல் லைக் ஃப்ரஸ்ட்ரேட்டிங், ஐம் எக்ஸாஸ்டட், ஸோ வை டோன்ட் ஐ கோ வித் த சேம். நவ் மை ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் கமெண்டிங் ஆன் மீ, ஐ கேன் நாட் கிவ் அப் அவுட் மை காஸ்ட்யூம். ஸோ த ட்ரெயினிங்ஸ் அண்ட் மோல்டிங் அ சைல்ட் ஷுட் பி எம்ஃபசைஸ்ட் அண்ட் ஷுட் பி கான்சன்ட்ரேட்டட் அட் அ வெரி யங் ஏஜ். பட் ஸ்டில் 15s இருக்காங்க சிஸ்டர், 14s ஆயிட்டாங்க சிஸ்டர், இப்போதான் எங்களுக்கு இதெல்லாம் தெரியுதுன்னு நினைக்கிற பேரண்ட்ஸ்க்கு ஜஸ்ட் அ ரிமைண்டர், வி ஸ்டில் ஹாவ் ஹோப்ஸ் இன் அ வெரி டிஃப்ரெண்ட் வே வித் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் பெர்ஸ்பெக்டிவ்ஸ். வென் வி ரியலி புட் இன் அவர் தவக்கல் டு அல்லாஹ், வி கேன் மேக் மிராக்கிள்ஸ், வி கேன் டெஃபினெட்லி பிரிங் இன் அ குட் அவுட்கம். நெக்ஸ்ட், டெமோக்ராட்டிக் பேரண்ட்ஸ், ஃப்ரீடம் வித்இன் லிமிட்ஸ். டெமோக்ராட்டிக் பேரண்டிங் இஸ் த மிடில் கிரவுண்ட் approach and is often considering the parenting ideal. Democratic parenting is based on warmth, love, guidance and positive discipline. I stress on that word called discipline. Whether it is good or bad, whether it is hard or easy, difficult or like really harsh, disciplinary is all about Islam. Moderation is all about Islam. Never fly too high, never fall beneath the earth. Never do that. Moderation is all about Islam. And we being a Muslim, being the role models, being the inspirations to so many people out there, we are supposed to be maintain that moderation. So the outcome will be happy, mostly self-reliant, mostly self-controlled, content, friendly, generous, cooperative and high achiever. Yes, குழந்தைங்க தான் தப்பு பண்ணுவாங்க தான், பட் என்கரேஜ் அண்ட் சப்போர்ட் யுவர் கிட்ஸ், பிகாஸ் சில்ட்ரன் ஆர் ஆப்ட் டு லிவ் அப் டு வாட் யூ பிலீவ் இன் தெம், வாட் யூ பிலீவ் இன் தெம். தே ஓன்லி நோ அஸ், நம்மளை மட்டும்தான் அவங்களுக்கு தெரியும். அந்த 10 இயர்ஸ் டு தி மேக்ஸ், 10 இயர்ஸ், 10 ஆர் 11 இயர்ஸ், நம்மள தவிர அவங்களுக்கு வேற ஃபாதர் ஆர் மதர் ஹீரோஸ் அண்ட் ஹீரோயின்ஸ் அந்த இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் நம்ம அவங்களுக்கு காமிக்கணும் வாட்ச் டிவி யூஸ் மொபைல் கோ டு தீஸ் வெப்சைட்ஸ் லிசன் டு த ப்ராஃபிட் ஸ்டோரிஸ் நம்ம அதை பார்க்க வச்சிட்டோம்னா பேரண்ட ஃபாதரை விட மதரை தவிர மீதி எல்லாமே இட் வில் பிகம் தேர் இன்ஸ்பிரேஷன்ஸ் அண்ட் the heroes and heroines of their lives and when they say who is your favorite they say like the website of so and so idu dhaan enak favorite they should see that my mother is my inspiration and my father is my role model because he had taught me this she had taught me that you have to be recognized and identified by your children that is the ultimate success of living my dear sisters and brothers I'm stressing on it once again எவ்வளோ பெரிய கலெக்டராக இருக்கலாம் இன்ஜினியர்ஸாக இருக்கலாம் டாக்டர்ஸாக இருக்கலாம் பட் அதெல்லாம் ஓகே ஃபைன் இன் ஒன் வே பட் யூனோ ப்ராக்டிக்கலி ஆனஸ்ட்லி அண்ட் யூனோ த ஹக் த ப்ரையாரிட்டி கோஸ் வென் யுவர் சைல்ட் சேஸ் தட் மை ஃபாதர் இஸ் மை ரோல் மாடல் மை மதர் இஸ் மை இன்ஸ்பிரேஷன் அண்ட் ஐ லேர்ன் சோ மச் ஃப்ரம் தெம் ஐ டோன்ட் பாதர் அபவுட் வாட் த அவுட்ஸ்கர்ட் ட்ரீட் மீ ஹவு தே டீல் வித் மீ பட் I have a person in hand. I have good personalities at home where I can ask anything I want and learn everything from them. So, technology ah irukkum veliya evlo periya aalungala yaaru enna deviation kodthalume they'll come back to us. They'll sit with us. Even though they are scared, they'll start, Mom, I want to speak to you. Mom, I have some words to, you know, utter. Remember that. Parenting with Islam in mind. So I think like it's almost 1:15. A small Islamic perspective to all my sisters and brothers. Few questions. Let's question ourselves.
Excuse me, sister?
Yes, sister.
Yes, you like to increase your voice a little bit?
Yeah, yeah. Sure, sure. So, parenting with Islam in mind. So these are all about the psychological perspective of parenting to all my brothers and sisters out there. Now towards our Islamic perspective, one simple surah, like it's a huge surah, but which teaches us ellarukkume puriyakoodiya murayila irukkira simple facts about Islam, parenting in Islam. From Surah Luqman, where Prophet Luqman alayhi salam had advised his son. Let's check it out. In the idhila irukkakoodiya 10 questions if we had asked and trained our children with it. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. It's the word of Allah, it's the teaching of a prophet, and I have experienced with my own children and with many of my clients, we will definitely find changes inshallah. So number 1, verse number 13, chapter number 31. O my son, join not in worship others with God. Verily, joining others in worship with God is a great wrong indeed. So it talks about tawheed, oneness in Allah, tawakkul in Allah. No matter what goes wrong or right, tawakkul, submission, complete submission, oneness in Allah. Never run behind the world, never run behind the worldly desires, never run behind the deviations and distractions of the shaitan. Have tawakkul, even if it is good or bad. Submit to Allah, ask Allah, seek Allah's help, seek refuge Allah's, like, you know, fear Allah's punishment. Have we taught that to our children? இந்த இடத்துல இதை ஒர்க் பண்ணு, அது கிடைச்சிரு, கால் தட் பேரண்ட், கால் தட் பிரதர், கால் தட் சிஸ்டர், இந்த ஷாப்ல போ, அது கிடைச்சிரு. Yes, of course, we have to guide them properly, but before that, before we give them suggestions and ideas, have we ever told them to go, ask Allah first, submit to Allah, take a day break, next day, or maybe take a 30 minutes of break, speak to Allah, get back to me. I will show you the way. I'll guide you properly. Have you ever done that? That is tawakkul. That is tawakkul. That is the submission. Believing in oneness. Believing in only one power, ultimate power. Next. And we have enjoined on man to be dutiful and good to his parents. Verse number 14. Next verse. So, have you or me ever taught or trained our children what are the duties towards their parents when they grow? Maybe we think like, okay, 25 years kaprama yen payan sambadipa adukaprama he'll take care of me. No, not at all. That's not the way to train our children about their dutifulness. From the age of 4, 3 and a half, 4, 5, 6, you must always be as a reminder, checklist to them to find out, did you check with your mother? Is she okay? Did you ask your papa? See, is he fine? Did he have his breakfast? Did you give him some water? This should be a question. You should train them. They are like clays. Clay. Remember that. So that's all about the second verse. We're teaching the children. You know, we have to explain them the duty and being attached and being great towards a parent when not during the time of distress, but every time, 24/7, like how we treat our children. We feed our children, we get them cakes, we get them biscuits, and we'll have to raise a question towards them. You do ever ask me, Mak venun kekalaya, akak venun kekalaya, apak papak venun kekalaya, and we have to question them. So once or twice, it will be a question where we start. The third time, they will definitely learn. Verse number 16. Oh, my son, if it be anything equal to the weight of a grain of mustard seed, and though it be in a rock or in the heavens or in the earth, Allah will bring it forth. The belief, the complete belief on Allah. Enna panaradhu idu ipdi poiduchu apdi poiduchu, I didn't score well, my mark is too low, my chachi is calling, my mama is yelling, idu seri varala, my friends are boycotting me, cornering me. We must teach them, we must explain this words. I'm just giving you the cherry above the cake, the color of the cherry above the cake. We have to dig it with the tafsirs, with the seerah, with the you know, hadiths, and explain them. Even if it is a atom bit of like grain alavukku kadugalukku irukra chinna vishayama irundalum rock alavukku irukra periya vishayama irundalum, if Allah wants us to happen, definitely that will be with us. Engiyum pogadhu. Don't worry about what is gone. Never ever, you know, feel low or get lost when things are not happening according to your wish. Work on it. Submit to Allah. Have tawakkul. Ask for khair, always khair. That will reach you if there is a goodness in it. And next verse. Oh, my son, offer prayer perfectly. We think, okay, kaalaila time cooler irudhu, thoongraanga kuzhandhainga, 6 years, 7 years thana, 9 years thana, paravaala, after that it's a long day to run. We ourselves give them permission to, you know, sleep well, relax themselves. Okay, you know, time irukku, you know, vakthuk time irukku. But remember, or fire accident nadakkira veetla, fire accident nadakkudhu, seri en kuzhandha thoongra illana TV paathittu irukkaan, nama vandu vittutona, what will happen to my child? Don't forget that. So it's a fire accident which can be like stopped within a minute, but don't forget about the fire which Allah speaks about, Jahannam, for the people who leave their salah. So we say like, ipo my child is not praying, tholuga matengraanga, correct follow panna matengraanga, but how have we trained? Never ever give them fears about, you know, practicing Islam, creativity. எப்பவுமே டோன்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் வித் ஹதீஸ் கால ரசூலுல்லாஹி ஸல்லல்லாஹு அலைஹி வஸல்லம் அப்படி இப்படி நரகம் சொர்க்கம் நல்லா நெவர் 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 பம்பார்ட் தெம் வித் ஃபியர் சிஸ்டர்ஸ் அண்ட் பிரதர்ஸ் டீச் தெம் இன் அ வே லைக் தே ஸ்டார்ட் லவ்விங் அல்லாஹ் தே ஸ்டார்ட் ரியலி ஃபோக்கஸிங் ஆன் அல்லாஹ் தே ஸ்டார்ட் ஹேவிங் கம்யூனிகேஷன்ஸ் அண்ட் நோ குட் டீலிங்ஸ் வித் அவர் ரப் தே ஷுட் டெல் அஸ் வாட் யூ ஷட் அப் மா ஐ நோ லைக் அல்லாஹ் கிட்ட நான் பேசிக்க நீங்க பேசாம போறீங்களா அப்படின்னு தே ஷுட் டெல் அஸ் இன் ஒன் டே தட்ஸ் ஹவு வி try to train them through salah. Salah makes a man perfect, even that can make a child too perfect. Remember that. Enjoin on people all that is good and forbid them from all that is evil. Teach them good and bad. Even if they fail to understand, keep on teaching them, keep on explaining them. Our brain has the tendency to take it. 10 தடவை சொல்லும்போது 11வது தடவை தன்னாலவே அது brain stop பண்ணிரும். So next time will be easy. We try once or twice. And then we say, no, my child is very arrogant. She has an attitude of not understanding things. No, don't do that. This is the command of Allah. Once again, a reminder. Teach them, enjoin on people all that is good and forbid them from evil. So we should know to segregate our children from good and evil. May it be the friends, may it be the, you know, group of people or the place they visit. நல்லது கெட்டது பிரிச்சு கொடுக்கறதுக்குண்டான ட்ரைனிங் நமக்கு இருக்கணும் அந்த எபிலிட்டி வி ஷுட் இன்கல்கேட் வித் இன் நெக்ஸ்ட் வேர்ஸ் செக் இட்ஸ் அ செக்லிஸ்ட் சிஸ்டர்ஸ் அண்ட் பிரதர்ஸ் டு ஆல் ஆஃப் அஸ் அப்படியே டிக் போட்டே வாங்க இதை நான் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கிறேன்னா இதை நான் டெய்லி டெய்லி ஆர் அட்லீஸ்ட் ஒன்ஸ் இன் அ வைல் இதை நான் வந்து செஞ்சுட்டு இருக்கேன் என் குழந்தைகிட்ட அப்படின்றது அண்ட் பேர் வித் பேஷன்ஸ் வாட் எவர் பிஃபால்ஸ் யூ டோன்ட் ஃபர்கெட் டு ஹாவ் சபர் பேஷன்ஸ் மேக்ஸ் எ பர்சன் இட் பிரேக்ஸ் எ பர்சன்ஸ் டூ இட் பிரேக்ஸ் எ பர்சன் டூ ஸோ பொறுமையோட நான் வந்து டீல் பண்ண முடியுதா எனக்கு அந்த பொறுமை எங்கிருந்து வருது இட்ஸ் நாட் அ இன்ஸ்டிங் சிஸ்டர் இட்ஸ் நாட் அட் ஆல் பொறுமையானவன் இன்ட்ரோவர்ட் அப்படின்றதெல்லாம் இஸ் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் தெர் ஆர் லைக் 10% பட் ரெஸ்ட் 90% இஸ் ஆல் அபவுட் ஹவு வி மோல்ட் ஹவு வி த பேக்ரோப் அண்ட் த பேக்ரவுண்ட் ஆஃப் அவர் ஆம்பியன்ஸ் நம்ம வளர்ந்து வர சூழ்நிலை நம்மளை சுற்றி இருக்கிற அட்மாஸ்பியர் என்வரான்மெண்ட் ஸோ இட் மேட்டர்ஸ் அ லாட் ஸோ பொறுமை அப்படின்றது நெவர் லைக் கிவ் அப் ஆன் இட் பேர் வித் பேஷன்ஸ் ஹேவ் சபர் கேட்ட உடனே கேட்கறக்கு முன்னாடி Before and all, ஒரு ஸ்வீட்டாக இருக்கட்டும் ஒரு சாக்லேட்டாக இருக்கட்டும் அவர் பேரண்ட்ஸ் யூஸ் டு கிவ் அஸ் ஒன் ஆர் டூ அண்ட் தே சே லைக் அவ்வளோதான் ஒன் வீக்கு இதுக்கு மேலே எதுவுமே கிடையாது பட் நவ் ஒன் கேஜிஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்வீட்ஸ் ஆர் சாக்லேட்ஸ் இஸ் பீன் லைக் யூனோ டிஸ்பிளேட் லைக் வாட் ஷாப்ஸ் கடையே வாங்கிட்டு வந்துட்டியாமான் குழந்தைங்க கேட்பாங்க ஆனால் இப்போ இந்த கிரைசிஸில் யூ டோன்ட் நோ ஹவு பீப்புள் லைக் ஹவு சில்ட்ரன் ஆர் அண்டர் கோயிங் மேஜர் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் அண்ட் ஆல் வாஸ் அபவுட் their past experiences இதுக்கு முன்னாடி இப்படி எல்லாம் இருந்தது இல்ல மேம் இதுக்கு முன்னாடி இப்படி எல்லாம் என் குழந்தைங்க எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பண்ணது இல்ல மேம் see this is where we have to you know seriously understand and seriously take this as a very serious note moderation இருக்கும்போது எல்லாமே செஞ்சிரலாம் it's easy but இல்லாதப்பவும் பழகிக்கணும் அது எப்போ when we have that ability of training ourselves and dealing treating our children with that attitude of moderation and poruma thanala varum palakathile experience la solli kudukra vidathile odane vaangi kuduthradinga ediyume train them what is sabr train them what is the real joy of receiving something after a long period of sabr we are failed in it 100% we never give a chance to our child to experience the real joy of collecting something through sabr and next and turn not your face away from men with pride peruma nee yaaru unakku evlo periya per irukku evlo periya panam irukku evlo periya pugal irukku nee avanga kitta la and watchman kitta and road street vendor kitta even kitta you shouldn't go no not at all come here to your car get in it ask your security or the watchman to open the door for you But what my Rabb says, and turn not your face away from men with pride. And the pride, we teach them, we train them, we tell them, Ivlo periyala, avlo periyala, unakku ivlo panam irukku, and you are the grandchild of so-and-so, you are the son of so-and-so. No, never ever. You make them understand we are just the dust, just the dust. We are like not equal or like unequal. We are just a human, slave of Allah and the humbleness. And humility should be always there in us. So never ever have that attitude of pride. That's the command of my Rabb. Do we do that? Check it out. Nor walk in insolence through the earth. Verily, Allah likes not any arrogant boaster. That's all about the same, like, you know, again, being arrogant, having attitude, and doing things and behaving. And our arrogance is not there. The first was the initial verses of my guidance, like the Quran, Al-Baqarah. So what Allah says is a holy book, is a guidance to everyone, not everyone, only the muttaqeen. Khudallil muttaqeen, don't forget that. So who are muttaqeens? Who are muttaqoons? The one who are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can we become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? By following, by understanding, by accepting, trying to implement, trying to apply, not like we can apply it instantly, but precisely, slowly, one, like every single day is an experience, try to apply it slowly, we'll become the closest person of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then Quran will become the guidance, inshallah. Ninth reminder, and be moderate or show no insolence in your walking, moderation, I have explained it, several times. So are we doing it with our children or within myself? And lower your voice. Verily the harshest of all voices is the braying of the ass. Never raise your voice. At the age of 3 and 4, I have to train my child not to raise his or her voice. But we fail. We say like, okay, it's okay, chinna kolana thana kattu all the abusive words. It's like nice to hear at the age of 3 and 4. Nalla irukku kekkuradhukku nu solli we ourselves motivate them to, you know, use those words. But when they grow higher, like adu palakkama poidu, our brain has the ability of storing things. விஷயங்கள் எல்லாமே வந்து ரொம்ப ரொம்ப வந்து மைண்ட்ல ஸ்டோர் ஆயிடும். ஸோ லேட்டர் ஆன் ஆஃப்டர் இயர்ஸ் இட்ஸ் வெரி டிஃபிகல்ட் ஃபார் தெம் டு கிவ் அப் ஆன் தோஸ் வேர்ட்ஸ். ஸோ இட் பிகம் தியர் ஹேபிட், இட் பிகம் தியர் பிஹேவியர். அண்ட் அப்போ வென் வி ஸ்டார்ட் ஸ்டாப்பிங், தே வில் பிகம் வயலண்ட் அண்ட் அக்ரெசிவ். செக் இட் அவுட், எத்தனை டிப்ஸ்க்கு ஹவ் கிவன் 10 டிப்ஸ் லைக் ஃப்ரம் சூரத் லுக்மான். Through the teachings of Prophet Luqman alayhi salam, may peace and blessings be upon him, may peace and blessings be upon all the Shahabas, all the prophets, may Allah raise them all in the highest ranks of Jannah. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Check it out, sisters. Speak to your children as if they are the wisest, kindest, most beautiful and magical humans on earth. For what they believe is what they'll become. So what you believe in them will be their belief, will become their belief, and what they believe will what they become. I hope you understood. It's a reminder again. What you believe in them will be their belief, and what they believe is what they'll become. End of the day. With parenting, there are no real answers at all. Instinctually, you do the right thing, it happens the way it's supposed to. Do the best you can. Everybody goes through difficulties with parenting. We all go through the joys of it and we go through the difficulties of it. It's the greatest journey. So I think like I've taken you towards a beautiful journey. And once more, like I would remind you about something, what a parent is. Being a parent is being there through the tantrums, the milestones and the tears. It's not like, yeah, I have given birth to my child, so let him grow by his own, or I have few do's and don'ts, so let him adopt to all those do's and don'ts. அப்படியே வளர்ந்துருக்கும்ன்றது கிடையாது. Being a parent is being there through the tantrums, the milestones and the tears. Being a parent means that you love that little person which Allah created through you. Loving that little person more than you could ever love yourself or anybody else. You'd readily, of course, you'll be lost like sleeps to comfort them from their nightmares, because you yourself require sleeps. It's okay, but when time comes, when they are in need, don't forget to comfort them. You would risk your own life for that small person. You'd surely die even to save them if you needed to. Ijtima, that's the power of a parent. Being a parent is never a burden. It's loving somebody else wholeheartedly and unconditionally. It's loving them wholeheartedly and unconditionally. அது புரியாம எனக்கே தெரியாது என் குழந்தை மேல இவ்வளோ ஒரு லவ், இவ்வளோ ஒரு அஃபெக்ஷன் இருக்கா அப்படின்றது. Until and unless I really feel that. Be lively, my dear brothers and sisters. Be lively. Never ever feel that, okay, it's my duty, responsibility. இல்லை, feel the joy of parenting. Experience the joy wholeheartedly and love them unconditionally. When can you love someone unconditionally? When you really have that feel. That's why I started my session with the passion of parenting. Being a parent to your child is not a job, it's a privilege. Cherish it. That's all from my side. May Allah accept it from all of us. Jazakallah khairan for this wonderful opportunity. And all the best to the team, all the best to Alfala and all the people, personalities who are working here. And once again, may Allah guide us in the straight path. May Allah help us to apply, reflect on whatever He had blessed us abundantly. Jazakallah khairan, sisters and brothers. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.